Hi there, and welcome to JetBlue Junior. My name is Captain Lewis, and I'm a pilot here at JetBlue. Today, we're at JetBlue University, and those are our flight simulators. And that's where we train all the pilots and all the crew members here at JetBlue. One of my favorite things about being a pilot is the view up from the sky. But if you ever looked out of the window of an airplane and saw nothing but clouds, you might wonder, how do pilots know where they're going? Well, that's what we're gonna find out today. The science of knowing where you are and where you're going is called navigation. Today, we're gonna show you some of the navigation tools that pilots use. And we're even gonna show you how to make one of your own.
For this activity, we're going to need a small paper clip, a refrigerator magnet, a bowl of water, a piece of thick construction paper, scissors, and a tape.
As you can see, the flight deck is full of instruments. Not that kind of instrument. An instrument can also mean a tool that helps you to do something. Like in this case, navigation. And as far as navigation is concerned, there are only six instruments that you need to know about. They even have a nickname, the six-man. You'll usually find some version of these six instruments front and center where the pilot can easily see them. Like in this airplane, they're on this big screen called the primary flight display, or as we call just the PFD.
First, we have the airspeed indicator. This measures your speed in knots, so you know how fast the plane is going.
Next, we have the attitude indicator. Do I have a good attitude or a bad attitude? Just kidding. Attitude means something different when it comes to flying. Have you ever looked at a sunset?
That straight line where the sky meets the ground is called the horizon. You always want to fly so the wings of the airplane are straight with the horizon line. So this tool helps you to fly straight. Next, we have the altimeter. This shows you how high up you are. In the middle of a normal flight, it would show that you are about 35,000 feet above the sea level. Here is the turn coordinator. Airplanes are really big and travel really fast, so turning can be a little difficult. And since clouds are always moving, sometimes it's hard to know if you're turning a lot or a little. This tool can help you know for sure. Over here is the heading indicator. This instrument is how you make sure that you're heading the right way. And last is the vertical speed indicator, which shows you how fast you're ascending or descending. As pilots, we learn to use these instruments, along with visual landmarks and calculations we make, to be sure we get to our destination safely. And while airplanes have changed a lot over the years, there is one piece of equipment that has been the MVP in airplane navigation, all the way back to the Wright brothers. Can you guess what it is? That's right, the compass. Even though it was invented thousands of years ago, the compass is still used every day. How does a compass work? Well, first let's look at a compass rose. It's just a circle that shows you which direction is which. But what do these letters mean? Those are our cardinal directions. North, east, south, and west. One way to remember what order they go in is to go clockwise. Never eat soggy waffles. That will help you to remember N for north, E for east, S for south, and W for west. The needle of a compass always points north, so no matter which way you turn, the compass will always tell you which direction you are facing. Like right now, the compass is pointing east.
Knowing how to read a compass is really important, but now you're going to learn something even better, how to build your own compass.
Something you might not know is that the entire planet has a magnet inside of it. The magnet runs straight through the center, so there is a magnetic pole in the north and a magnetic pole in the south. That's why the most important part of the compass is the magnetized needle.
So, remember that paper clip we found earlier? First, we're going to straighten out. Remember to be careful doing this or ask an adult for help. Next, we're going to magnetize it. That's where your refrigerated magnet comes in. All you have to do is rub the paper clip against the magnet in the steady, even strokes. Keep going the same direction, not back and forth. And after about 40 strokes, the paper clip should be magnetized. Okay, next, you're going to take your scissors and paper and cut out a circle, not too small. Now, get a little piece of tape and tape your newly magnetic compass needle right in the middle. Alright, now here comes the hard part. Watch careful. You're going to take the paper and drop in the bowl of water. And that's it. Now, just watch the compass needle slowly move itself until it points to the north. And there you have it. You've made your own compass.
So now that you're master of navigation, let's start planning your next trip. What's your dream destination? Which direction you're gonna take to get there? I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson. I know I did. Thanks for joining me today at JetBlue Junior, and happy flying. From all of us here at JetBlue, thanks for flying with us. My name is Captain Lewis, and I hope to see you in the air soon.